Hi students, this is Ganesh. Welcome to Rank 1 Test Series Academy. Today I am going to discuss semiconductor devices. Here I am showing some of the semiconductor devices we are using in televisions, cell phone and laptop, etc. Before we are going to discuss semiconductor devices, we must know what are the semiconducting materials we are used here. Semiconductors. So semiconductor is solid state electronic device. Before we are going to see that semiconductor, we must know what is conductor and what is insulators. So insulators sometimes is called as dielectrics. So conductors, already we know that conductors allows the current inside it, okay, but insulator is resist the current, is does not allow the current flowing through it. Example of conductor is copper, aluminium, silver and gold, etc. Here I gave the example of insulators also. So glass and dry wood and rubber, diamond and ebonite. Here I give the energy gap values for insulators. It is greater than or equal to 3 electron volt. Now I am coming to semiconductors. Semiconductor, the name itself is giving semi. Semi means is partial. Partial conductors. Sometimes it's actors. It acts sometimes partially conductor and insulator. Sometimes it acts as conductor and sometimes it acts as insulators. So here I give one questions. What is conductor and when will it act as conductor and when will it act as insulators? This is my questions. When this semiconductor is act as conductor and when this semiconductor is act as insulator. The example of semiconductor is germanium and silicon is the elemental semiconductor. Is also called as indirect band gap semiconductor. So germanium and silicon is a fourth group of element in the periodic table. It's having energy gap is 0.7 electron volt and 1.1 electron volt. The uses of semiconductor is diode and transistor. Already we are seeing that in first slide. And here the compound semiconductor is also called as dielectric band gap semiconductor, sorry, direct band gap semiconductors. And the compound semiconductor of example is gallium arsenide and indium phosphate, zinc oxide, zinc sulfate, etc. This zinc oxide, zinc sulfate is second and sixth group of element in periodic tables. Here is third and fifth group of element in the periodic table. So conductivity changes due to increase in temperature and adding an impurities. The conductivity of semiconductor changes because of increase in temperature and adding an impurities. Due to increase in temperature, it's called as intrinsic semiconductor because it is pure, is only germanium and silicon. When you increase in temperature in germanium and silicon, the broken covalent bonds, okay, therefore the conductivity is increased. The germanium is having 32 electrons and silicon having 14 electrons. It is a tetravalent atom, that is 4 electrons in the outermost orbit, that is 4 valence electrons, okay, therefore it is called as tetravalent atoms. Here another way to increase the conductivity, to change the conductivity by adding an impurities, therefore it is called as extrinsic or impure semiconductor. Sometimes it is also called as doped semiconductor. Here the germanium silicon with adding an arsenic, antimony, bismuth, phosphor, that is the pentavalent atoms. So outermost orbit, it's having 5 valence electrons. Therefore, it is called as this arsenic, antimony, bismuth, phosphor is called as pentavalent atom. Same way, indium, boron, aluminium, gallium is added into the pure semiconductor. The conductivity is changes. That is trivalent atoms. It is the outermost orbit is having 3 valence electrons. So, what are the limitations of intrinsic semiconductor? It can be direct, it cannot be directly used to fabricate device due to the limitations. What are the limitation means? Sigma is conductivity. okay, it is denoted as sigma. The conductivities, it is denoted as sigma. Sigma is low. Germanium having 1.67 per ohm meter. Conductivity in terms of ohm meter, per ohm meter, 1.67 is 10 power 7 times lesser than the copper. And this conductivity sigma is depends on temperature. It's different places acting different temperature, different temperatures is given, different conductivities is given. The conductivities cannot be controlled from the outside. These are the limitations of intrinsic semiconductor. Extrinsics are impure or doped semiconductor. At low temperature, the carrier concentrations of extrinsic semiconductor of electron and holes are very low. Okay, at low temperature means at room temperature, the carrier concentrations of electrons and holes are very low. Therefore, conductivity is not enough. Therefore, to get appreciable current density, added suitable impurities into it. That is, suitable impurities means pentavalent and trivalent atoms. Already we have seen arsenic, antimony, that values, and indium, boron, like, etc. Okay. Thank you. So, in the video, like பண்ணுங்க, comment பண்ணுங்க, bell button click பண்ணி, subscribe பண்ணுங்க.